This is Maganda Marie with Best Friends Forever. I am really bad at making intros, so let's do this. Last time, I kind of just left it off with, Astrid, that's right. I got done meeting Astrid and Felix, the two people that I was like, huh, they're pretty hot. But they're also kind of douchey, and that makes me a little upset. Hopefully they're nicer once you actually get to know them. Maribel Summers. Industrial District. Best flat white in rainbow. What's a flat white? Okay. Also, there's a lot of cars outside. Go see Maribel. It says she's at a local cafe. Let's go get a puppuccino brisket. Took a little while, but I eventually found it. Every time I start this video, you have to take a little fart. The shop front is modest, barely distinguishable from the surrounding units, and only a small sign declares the place to be named Cool Story Brew. I actually really like that name! The queue almost reaches around the block. A mix of people fill the sidewalk, from bearded and bespectacled hipsters to well-dressed professionals exuding impatience. There's a few tables dotted around the pavement, and the most are taken up by people sporting a sideways sit, as if they were royalty riding into the village on their white steed. I read that wrong, but whatever. Or more likely, awaiting a takeaway order. Stop. Just as I take another step towards an opening the door, a piercing sound spills to the air. I can hardly tell where it's coming from, or what it is. It sounds like a squeaky toy. Or five squeaky toys. Oh, no. Five very loud squeaky toys. He isn't too pleased about
the noise. Here, gravy!
Gravy. Gravy? That is... Briskets and gravy! Aww. What kind of dog is this? What kind of dog is it? A Pomeranian. Dang it! Tiny dog! Oh, that's okay. Tiny dogs can be cute. I guess I just didn't see the dog amongst all the hustle and bustle. That and it's tiny. Briskets. Oh, am I thinking biscuits and gravy? Is brisket and gravy a thing? It has to be a thing. It sounds delicious. Brisket and gravy. Hey there. Maybe I should have named him Biscuit. No, I'm just kidding. I see you make gravy. Sorry about the barking. She's just a little shy. I'm sorry, her name is Gravy? No? Yeah, but that's just a nickname. It's short for Grave Digger. Grave Digger? Oh, of course. Doesn't she look like a grave digger to you? Gravy yips in agreement and smiles broadly, her small tongue out and proud. Doesn't she get hot in there? Nope, check it out. This is a Pup Pack 3000 with reinforced acrylic doggo vision viewing station, 47 unique ventilation points, and built-in organic pheromone diffuser. This bad boy is the latest and greatest in pup accessories and is the perfect mobile home for the bestest of girls. Yes, that's you, Gravy. Yes, it is. What about this little doggo? The woman squats down impressively fast and holds out her hand to Brisket. Brisket licks her hand and bows their head to a maximum pat. What a little cutie. This is Brisket. I just got him recently. Well, it's very lovely to meet you, Brisket.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
You must be new to town if you're a recent adopter. What brought you out to Rainbow Bay? You know, life. Nothing to do with a mystical dog wizard or anything. Dog wizard? Nope, nothing. I was so intrigued. Anyway, I should really get going. I have to get Gravy to daycare before my next meeting. See you around sometime? Nope. Really poor timing, Brisket, stop! Before I can respond, the woman power walks away with Gravy yiping and friendly goodbye from her pup palace. I like her. Gravy looks pretty comfy up there, doesn't she, Brisket? Works. Barely 30 seconds pass before I see the same woman veering around the corner and powering through me, towards me again. I've seen you before. What? I just remembered. On Woofer, right? We got matched. Oh, yeah, I didn't think you recognized me.
Hey, I'm Maribel. Urban planner and Pomeranian lover.
I talked to everyone, I'm so sorry. But yes, that is what you are. She extends a hand to shake. It is distressingly sweaty. I guess she broke a sweat sprinting back here. Okay, that's fine. was lovely to meet you. We should meet again. Get to know each other a little better. I swear I'm not always in this much of a rush. Let's exchange emails.
Gotta keep moving.
Of course, I'll be in touch. Maribel jogs away once more, leaving me with her email address scribbled on the back of a piece of paper. It looks like a receipt for one protein bar. For $10? She seems like a whirlwind of fun, huh, Brisket? I crouch down to pet Brisket, subtly wiping my sweat-covered palms onto his fur. Boy, you gonna take that sweat and you gonna like it. Well, I guess we should keep on moving. It's been a busy day. Stop it! Stop! We've been all over the city, but there's still so much left to explore. For now, I think it's best to rest our weary feet and pause. No, come here, boy. Brisket drags his feet a little as we make our way through the streets of the Arts District. Looks like someone will be ready for naps when we get home. Looking around, the Arts District seems like it's starting to wind down for the day. A few cafes are closing up and there's all around less hustle and bustle. The sun casts long shadows, painting the street with stripes of dark brown and gold. Still, some of the residents of Rainbow Bay are lounging outside bars, basking in the late afternoon sun with their dogs. Others are simply drifting through, transient with no hurry at all. Boy? As I wander along, I feel a sharp tug at the end of Brisket's leash. Uh-huh. I whip my head around to see Brisket is rooted in place outside. A shop front, staring in and standing alert. What is it, Brisket? My eyes wander upwards to read a small, indistinct sign hanging in an otherwise blackened out window. Fox's Tavern and Bar? Boy, get over here. You want to go in, Brisket? He shuffles up to the door and paws gently at the glass. I guess that's a yes. I have no idea what I'm about to discover, but I have a feeling it's going to be like anything from New Yonk. New Yank. As I pull the door open, light spills into an almost completely dark room. Save for a low orange light filling the space, the shop rests in shadow. It's almost uncomfortably hot in here. I don't think there's a single open window in this place. I'm not sure they're open, Brisket. Despite my complaints, Brisket shuffles forward, sniffing the ground like a bloodhound on the hunt. No, stop, you're not cowering. I follow Brisket through the shop, which is clearly neither a tavern nor a bar. We wander through aisles of glass enclosures housing all manners of curious creatures. I recognize a few of them. Chinchillas, tree frogs, hedgehogs. Beyond that, there's an assortment of hamsters, fish, lizards, and a snake. Oh geez, it's okay, Brisket. It's behind glass. Man, what is this place?
Welcome.
Oh, to my humble abode. Why is everything in this shop trying to give me a heart attack? Oh, you don't like snakes? I love snakes. Standing behind me is an impish woman wrapped tightly in more layers than I can fathom. Amongst her ginger locks and the fur of her hood sit two small birds, each the opposite of the other, one brightly colored and the other monotone. Come now. Yes. Great. Welcome to... she has the Australian accent, doesn't she? I don't have that accent. Welcome to Fox's Tavern and Bar, a cornucopia of obscure pets and pet accessories. I'm Fox. Oh, this is a pet shop. I thought everyone adopted from the clinic here. That's right. I mostly sell exotic animals. So, you don't sell dogs? No, you should adopt a dog, not buy one. Oh, yeah, I'm not looking for one, I was just wondering. Brisket doesn't want a new friend? Hey, how did you... You said his name just a moment ago, Maganda. Oh, right, wait. Anyway, I'm actually getting ready to close the shop for the day. Is there anything specific I can help you with? Neither a tavern nor a bar. And that's not a question. Touche, Fox. Touche. But to answer the question you didn't actually ask, it's a tavern and bar for animals. They come here and stay with me. I feed them, listen to their woes, tend to their aching hearts. Tell me how that doesn't sound like a tavern and or bar. Do you offer that same service to humans?
Nope.
Pity. Does anyone buy exotic pets? What do you mean? I mean, this is the world's most dog-friendly city, right? Why would anyone here buy a chinchilla? Maybe they like chinchillas. I suppose. I also sell designer pet accessories. Oh, like leashes? Some leashes, yeah. Dog? Take a dump in people's stores? Can I see them? Not yet. What does that mean? Why is it so dark in here? So they're awake in the daytime. Who? Them. She gestures at the glass enclosures around us. Everyone in this part of the store is nocturnal. Well, not everyone. You don't count. Oh. Ouch. Do you know there are birds on your shoulder? Do you think I wouldn't be aware of that? The colorful one is Melanie, and the goth one is Phoebe. They're lovebirds. I love lovebirds so much. Oh, they're together? I mean, they're literally lovebirds. But also, yes, they're together. Cute. Hold up, do I recognize you? Wait a minute. Have I seen you somewhere before? Oh no. Is this a pickup line? No, I swear, there's just something so familiar about you. I don't recognize you. Sorry. I feel like maybe I saw you online? It's a small city. You probably just saw me on the street. Wait, your voice! Like, how would you recognize a person's face? I'm from the radio. No. You're that animal expert, Fox Ainsworth. You were on the radio when I was on the bus. Your parents are Steph and Terry Ainsworth, the zookeepers, right?
Yeah.
You caught me. I gotta take my legs off this chair. Why does this chair have to be leather? It hurts. Fox Ainsworth, Rainbow Bay's local wildlife expert and bird law prodigy. Bird law! I know bird law! And yes, they are my parents. Next question. Oh, I don't think I actually have any more questions. Great. Feel free to come by if you ever need something, but for now, I'd really like to go home. Right, sorry. I didn't mean to bother you. I just followed Brisket. Brisket must have some pretty good taste. Look after each other. I can tell he's a special one. Yes, ma'am.
Bye-bye now.
But seriously, leave. Right. I hope she's not a dating option, because she's kind of mean. Ugh, home at last. Me too, Brisket. Me too. We've been so busy lately, I think we both deserve an early night. There are some really cool people around here. What do you say we invite them all over once we're unpacked? Gross, don't lick me. I'll take that as a yes, though. Let's give it a few weeks, and then we'll send out some invitations. But first, we should probably do your training session, huh? Are you ready? Okay, so I want smarts and sociability up. So, Puppuccino. Let's see, I did that one for fitness and manners. I don't want to do manners because I'm already level 2. Let's see, fitness and sociability. Let's see. Wait, that one's also fitness and sociability. Let's do that one instead. Smarts, no. Fitness and trust. Yeah. Let's see. Trust and sociability. Ooh. There needs to be more smart ones, but we'll do pup flicks and chill. Run. Brisket went to town to his Puppuccino and quickly moved on to sniffing other dogs' buttholes. Brisket tried to weave between your legs while running, but otherwise kept pace. Aww. Brisket convinced the local surfer to let him hang 10. Cowabunga, dude! Over the course of the nap, Brisket slowly put- Aw, come on, Brisket. Brisket got excited during a werewolf transformation and practiced his best howl. Let's see, level 2. Okay, so smarts and sociability still need to go up. Oh my gosh, his satiation is so low. Let's wet food ya. Now that I know how to do this. Oh, you're so dirty. Why do you have all this stuff on you? Energy. Satiation's up. Tend? How for energy? Energy and hygiene. Okay, let's do this. Nope, Biscuit's right ear. it's actually his left ear. What? His face was dirty. I wanted to clean him more. Rise and shine. It's week 3. Oh, I don't even have to wake up anymore. Inbox.
Hello. Hi, good friend. Please contact me if you would like to change your life. Respond only if you are the owner of this mail address. And $50,000, please. I have a life change opportunity for you. It is a worthwhile investment. Please reply to this email. Do not delete this or you will die in 7 days.
Sale. Buy one. Get one free groundhogs. Tavern and bar. Ever wanted a squirrel but bigger? Well, boy howdy, do I have the deal for you. Today only, we have a special buy one, get one deal on groundhogs. Groundhogs are the biggest cousins of squirrels, otherwise known as woodchucks. They are known for digging holes, burrows, up to 6 feet deep, and so can be very useful companion if you are in the grave digging business. Your pet's groundhog will most likely sleep all through winter, so you're really making a huge savings on pet food. Buy now before the deal's gone. Paws Academy check-in reminder. Quincy here. Finger gun gun. Thanks for signing up to Paws Academy. We hope you're having a great time caring for your new best friend forever. This is just a courtesy email from the team at Paw Prince Pet Care Center to remind you that Brisket is due for a check-in in 3 weeks' time. During this check-in, we'll assess how your dog's training is going and where your little friend is sitting compared to all other pups. See you then! Is your life insured? It should be. Are you feeling down and out on your luck? The news really getting to you lately? Well, never fear, because with Obelisk Life Insurances, there's always a higher being looking out for you. What is Obelisk Life Insurance, I hear you ask? Why, it's everything you could ever need and more. Protect yourself from the natural from the threat of suddenly dying on the toilet. Ensure your family has something to Ensure your family has something to remind you by when that inevitably happens anyway. And rest assured your body won't just be added to the pile somewhere, but buried in a very large hole all by itself that raises questions about the sustainability of land use as a burial site. When the news is frightening and the belt is tightening, Obelisk keeps your smile widening. That's creepy. Okay. So there wasn't really anything information-wise from anyone. We have Astrid. I do like him. He's pretty cool. She was okay. I really liked her. I really liked him too. Personal time! I'm gonna pass on you, Felix. Sorry, you're kind of a dick. Let's see, smarts and social. I'll do smarts because my dog's kind of dumb. Yes, please. We needed a dog model for today's photo shoot, and Brisket was just the dog for the job. Thanks to all our practice, Brisket could sit, stay, and lie down for a good hour before getting bored. Yes, level 2! Oh, it's only 1, 2. Okay. I'm gonna go to Anders Hansen. The acoustic chanteur. I don't know how that's pronounced, but I just winged it. Dog? We go to this fancy-ass place, and the first thing you do is fart? As soon as I step into the cafe, I spot Anders sitting at the bar nursing one of those tiny espresso cups. What? Who drinks actual short-black espressos?
Oh.
I'd recognize that barking anywhere. How are you this fine afternoon, Brisket? No. Anders looks up at me as I pull out the stool beside him. You come here often? I'm still new here. I don't really go anywhere often yet. What about you? I don't think karaoke would be your jam. Oh, I didn't think. They don't make bro karaoke, no, but I have a few favorites I know by heart. Not that. That's not known by heart. Get out of here, Brisket. Like Banjo V's Lizard on a Chair. But honestly, I prefer to come here when it's quiet. I mean, what do you think about karaoke? For me, it's fun for everyone. I love it. Who doesn't love karaoke? It doesn't matter how well you sing. It's all about having shameless fun. That's a nice way to look at it. I'll try that approach next time. Hey, 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 hey. Next time Robin gets to the microphone. I'm afraid to ask any follow-up questions, but Anders seems to appreciate my outlook. Oh, it's really short. I want you. Come with me to the tavern and bar. Oh, is she gonna get a hedgehog? Okay. I've got her wearing the hard hat and- Oh, no, she buys clothes. And she seems to love it. I guess it helps that it's kind of necessary. You know, I don't think a hard hat would effectively protect a Pomeranian on a construction site. Unless it was over her entire body. That would be so cute!
Oh,
a little hard hat running around with Pomeranian feet. I'm looking for something to dress Gravy up in for formal event, though. Don't suppose you have any ideas? No, she's a gravedigger. She's not going to wear something like that. Too princessy. But a corsage. That's pretty classy. How formal is it? Maybe you could put together a corsage and attach it to her collar. That is genius. It would have to sit on the back of her neck, but that could work. You don't sell DIY corsage kits, do you, Fox? This is a pet shop, Maribel. Of course I do. Brilliant. Maribel seemed to really like that idea, and Gravy will look so cute. I'm glad I can help. You're really cool. I like you. Let's go with you.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, the dog's in a shark outfit! Hey, Maganda. Fancy seeing you here. I was just about to take Marshmallow out of the park for walkies and fetchies, but it's raining now. Marshmallow crazy set up the eyeball slash excitedly. It's honestly a pretty mild response, but I guess- Oh, I was hoping it would say something about him wearing the shark outfit. Marshy loves apartment living, but when the zoomies strike, it's time to get outside. I'm not really sure what to do if we can't go to the park. Any ideas? Apartment Ninja Warrior! Why not turn your apartment into an obstacle course? Ooh, we could make cute little hurdles for Marshy to jump over. Marshmallow yips in approval. Sasha does too. Did I say Sasha? Sorry, Sacha. My bad. Let's work on your social. Jade asked me to take class of 2020 photos for Paws Academy Academy. Brisket was so polite to the other dogs and didn't even chase the Chihuahua, mostly because it was the other way around. Yes, everything's level 2! Oh, never mind. These are still level 1. What? It's a level 2. Whatever. Social and smarts. 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 Okay. Let's do work the runway. I'm looking for only social and smarts. Kind of stuff. Smarts. See, social. And. Let's do some more trust too. Social. Doggy daycare. Okay. Run week. Brisket went to town on his peppuccino and then sniffed buttholes. Brisket didn't want you to remove his jacket after the first runaway outfit. Brisket's play dead was really good. Within 5 minutes, Brisket was in a butt-sniffing circle. They smelled some new friends. Brisket made some new friends and coerced Quincy into giving everyone extra treats. Aw, Brisket, you troublemaker. Everything is now level 2. Your satiation is so low. Eat it. Eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it. Nice. Satiation minus a satiation. Mood, hygiene, and plus hydration. Yeah, let's clean you. That didn't get rid of the spots on his face, though. That's like 3 things is not really long enough, you know? Oh well. Okay, there's Anders, Maribel, smarts, social.
First date?
Yes, let's do it. Oh, wait, hold on. I got emails. Woofer dating tip 1, spend time together.
When you're looking for love, it can be hard to make things stick.
Sending each other, they didn't put a space there, memes may be one way to flirt. But when it comes to courting cuties you met on Woofer, there's no better way than spending quality time face to face. So go on, get out there and engage in as many encounters with your would-be beau as possible. Who knows? If you say the right thing, you might even be on the fast track to Date City. NB, Date City is not a real place.
Oops. Are your teeth in danger?
We noticed you haven't been to see us here at Smile High Club for some time. Dental hygiene is vitally important, particularly in these dangerous, unprecedented times. 63% of people over 25 report a big drop in bite strength and tooth solidity year after year. 30% of women say their biggest concern this decade is chewing or chew-related activities. 1 in 2 respondents to a recent survey reported having dreams about their teeth falling out and starting a revolution in a small island nation. Come and see us immediately. You owe it to your mouth. Sign up to our new Red Alert plan and get 10% off your first drilling.
I don't want no drilling.
Okay, daytime. Industrial District, let's go see her. Maribel recognized me from Woofer, so maybe she's keen on a date. Hopefully I'm not reading into it that much. Hi, what are you doing tomorrow? Hello, just working. Always working. Oh, damn. I was wondering if you wanted to hang out together. Ooh, like a date? Something like that? Maybe? Another time if you're busy? Come on. Oh, oh my god, no, I would love to. Oh my god, let's make it work. I'll squeeze you in. Is that a winky face? That's a winky face. She's gonna squeeze me in. You know Cool Story Brew? Tiny little cafe? It's where we met. Let's get a coffee. 1 p.m. my treat. Okay, sounds great. Heart. Wow, that was painless. If only it was normally this easy to ask people out. Cool Story Brew was as busy as ever. Typically of the lunchtime rush, the colorful patronage are queued around the block, and the chatter of the crowd is only broken by the coffee calls of a small barista with an impressive yell. Fearing how brisket might age in the time it takes me to order, I hesitantly move forward to the end of the queue. Maganda, over here! I turn in the direction of Maribel's voice to spot her waving to me excitedly from a faraway table. I wave back at her before promptly gesturing towards the line. Doggo no! Ahead of me, Maribel grins widely and holds up 2 reusable coffee cups. There is a god, and her name is Maribel.
Your gravy!
Arriving at the table, I notice Gravedigger is comfortably on Maribel's back, peering over at the table.
Oh, hi, Gravy.
You made it. I sure did. I got you a coffee. Not sure what you like, so it's just a flat white.
A what now?
You know, a flat white. Super trendy. Objectively the best type of coffee. Does it have any caramel syrup in it? Nope, but I'll remember that for next time. For now, there's sugar on the table if you need it. And for Gravy, I got a big cappuccino, because that's what she deserves, yes it is. Clearly talking about the bowl splattered with remnants of milk foam sitting in front of her. It's almost 2 times the size of the Pomeranian's face. As Maribel starts routinely doting over Gravy, I take the shifted attention as an opportunity to upend the sugar jar over my coffee. Sweet, sweet sugar. Light of my life. Fire of my impending health issues. Anyway, I'm not here for Gravy. I'm here for you. I mean, technically I'm the cock, so I'm not here for either of you, but that's why I schedule my site visits around lunchtime. What the boss doesn't know, right? Oh, you're working today? We could have waited until the weekend.
Oh.
No, shush. Don't be silly. I need an excuse to take a longer lunch. The urban planner life is not as glamorous as you might think. Ooh, that reminds me. I don't actually know what you do. You must be pretty flexible if a weekday lunch wasn't an issue. Yeah, you can say that. I'm self-employed now, trying to make it as a photographer. So if you know any events and need photos, let me know. Oh my god, you should photograph Gravy. I'll pay you, of course. Oh, sure, we can arrange that sometime. Great. Now then, it's question time. She narrows her eyes and curls lips against a level of mischief I'm not entirely sure I should trust. Would you rather live in an apartment or a detached house? I want a house with a yard. I live in an apartment now, but... Get over here. I would love to have a proper house with a yard. I think Brisket would like that too. Yeah, I can understand where you're coming from. That's an interesting thing about Rainbow Bay. We have so many dogs, but just like any city, it's getting harder and harder to buy a home with a section. Fortunately, we've managed to achieve the best rental laws in the country, so having a pet inside isn't much of a problem. But we need to be careful when we adopt to make sure we're giving our dogs some chance at happiness as us. Apartments get a bad rap, but a lot of dogs are very adaptable to little living, and not just the small ones. Wow, you sure have a lot of options, opinions about apartments. Urban planner, remember? It's my job to have opinions. Okay, next question. Would you change your way of life if it would improve the lives of hundreds? Of course. The sacrifice of one for the benefit of many? Hard to argue against that. I appreciate your altruism. I think too many people are quick to choose their own simple comforts over the genuine well-being of others. Like, if your taxes increased just 1%, it would be relatively little money out of your pocket. But that would all pool together to help fund public education or fight poverty. Yet there are ways people... But there will always be people who see taxes as theft. Rainbow Bay could be... Or could use more people like you. Wait, so me saying I wanted a house was a bad answer then? Fuck. What's with all these questions anyways? I'm testing you. Wait, what? I'm just interested in your perspective. I deal with these sorts of issues a lot, so it's a lot on my mind. Or it's all on my... whatever. But if you really want me to test you, who's cuter out of Brisket and Gravy? I plead the fifth. No way. Nope, I refuse. There is no safe answer to this question.
Oh, come on.
Coward! That's fine. I think we both know who's the most special, wonderful, adorable little princess in the wide world. Yes, it's you, Gravy. Yes, it is. Next question? Ready to move on from that one, huh? Alright, let's see. Why did you really move to Rainbow Bay? What do you mean? Before I can finish my sentence, the familiar sound of a phone alarm cuts me off. Marble excitedly reaches down to the backpack sitting by her feet and pulls out her phone. My lunch break is up. I have to head off to a build site nearby before I go back to town hall. Oh, you should come with me.
It's just
a quick inspection to check how the development is going. It'll be super fast. And I can tell you all about the development too. Come on. What do you say? Oof. Are you allowed to bring strangers on a development site? Probably. I'm taking that as a yes. Let's go. Marble shoots up out of her seat, bringing Gravy with her backpack with her. After securing the Pomeranian inside her bubble, she takes my hand and gently pulls off my feet. Ooh, your hand's not sweaty this time. Huh? Did I say that out loud? Just for that, you're going to have to hold my hand the whole way there. Curses. It's only a short walk until we're at the development site on the outskirts of the industrial district. Temporary chain link fences enclose the grounds, though they don't look like they'd be very effective against any determined trespasser. It looks like construction's not far along, with the materials dotted around the site and only the beginnings of a structure. Marble held my hand the whole way over and only lets go to get a hard hat for herself and Gravy. Oh god! Gravy looks so cute in her little hard hat. Has Gravy been there the entire time? Because I had not seen her. Honestly, she just kind of blurred in. She's the sweetest. There isn't a Brisket-sized hard hat. Sorry. That's his answer to that. It's okay, we'll just wait here. Won't be long, I promise. Right. She straightens her back, drops her shoulders, and marches blank-faced into the site. From afar, I can see her interacting with the site manager, behaving with a sort of rigidity and seriousness in stark contrast to the way she normally acts. It's honestly like a whole other person just stepped past the chain-link fence. Speaking of the fence, only once Marble walked away did I realize each piece of fencing is adorned with signs for an all-too-familiar company. A jingle rings through my mind. Scraping the sky and never asking why, that's the obelisk construction way of life. Oh god. What's wrong? Why are we screaming? No sneaking. Sneaking is bad. Anyways, or always pay attention to your surroundings on a construction site. That's a fair point. So, what's the deal with this development? It's a project of mine. It's a project of mine. The first of hopefully many. It's an apartment building. Oh no, I did say the wrong thing. The first high-rise outside of South Shore. Basically, the industrial district is the main residential area of Rainbow Bay, but almost all housing is detached. There's a lot of demand for the area, but no affordable housing. So I'm fighting for high-rise apartment blocks. If we want to grow as a city, the only way is up. So this is the start of your legacy as the urban planner? Oh no, my legacy is going to be a statue of gravy on Fenrir Island. Actually, this development kind of skipped the queue, thanks to Obelisk. Somehow they found out we were accepting projects and they had enough money to make their own schedules. Wow, I need to take a break after this, because my eyes... After this date, I'm gonna cut it. Yeah, Obelisk can be like that. Doesn't sound like you're a fan. Well, I mean, I used to work for them. Oof, messy breakup? Let's not get into that right now. To be honest, they're not my favorite either. But they did agree to our controlled unit sales prices, so I guess they're not that bad. Maybe even giant multinational tech corporations led by faceless billionaires are capable of doing some good. Let's hope that's true. Anyway, I have to head back to the town hall now. Wanna walk with me? She doesn't even wait for an answer and quickly grabs my hand. Judging from her power walk, I'd wager she's running late or something. Well, here we are. Oh, I never noticed the town hall was right here. It's pretty well hidden. Just an office building, really.
Gotta keep moving.
All right, I'll leave you here. It was lovely spending time with you. True to form, Maribel moves before I can really react. She ducks forward and plants a small kiss on my right cheek, and then quickly trots away. I watch Gravy staring out of her bubble at the warmth of Maribel's kiss lingers on my cheeks. I can hardly keep up. Yeah, I like her too, Brisket. I actually do. She's really cool and cute at the same time. Okay, that's what I'm gonna do. Okay. That was a long one, and my eyes hurt. Because I have it windowed and the screen's so tiny. So the words are really tiny. Okay. I'll see you guys in part 4. Bye.